Hey people, Rio Wolfhard here. I want to do a series where I just choose songs and do a little commentary on them. I want to do a little analysis, dissect those songs and just talk about them. Maybe play along with the guitar. The first song that I've chosen is Holy Ground from a band called the Dead Daisies. I've chosen that song because of Doug Aldrich. Doug Aldrich is one of those guitar players that just, when I hear it, I just want to pick up my guitar and start playing. So he's inspiring to me. And as for the other bands, it's going to be the same thing. I'm going to choose bands that just inspire me, that I want to listen to anyway, and that I really want to dig into those songs and see what the songwriting is about, how the riffs are structured and stuff like that. So yeah, here we go. The first riff is like a pendulum riff. It just switches around between the first and the seventh position, and then you have this little... I guess it's better to play it right here. This kind of riff actually reminds me of like a stoner riff, like a Monster Magnet style. Yeah, so that's just what my mind reminds me, and then you have that little... Pretty cool. The verse is built up like this. You have this chord. Whoopsie. And it changes to the third. So it's the first position, the third. Just keep singing, and he plays the third right here. Okay? Chorus. This is from the intro. Pretty cool riff. So the pre-chorus basically is first position, third position, and fourth. And then the second time, you have this little, I guess you call it a turnaround. Let's keep on listening. So basically, this is the same thing again as the first verse. This kind of verse always changes between like open chords and the riff. So it's kind of like an A-B structure. It's pretty popular in rock music. And it's actually pretty remarkable what Glenn Hughes is playing on the bass, because he's not just playing the roots of each chord, and that's it. He's playing like crazy melodious lines, like, and he's doing that while he's singing. Well, not on this record actually, but if you listen to live recordings, he plays like that. He plays crazy melodic lines with slides and all kind of cool shit, and while he's singing, so it's incredible. Back to pre-chorus. Oh, right here on pre-chorus, I missed that the first time. By the way, I don't think it's like this. It's always without a third. For example, the A chord would be like this, and the C. Try not to play the third. Pretty cool. It's the bridge with the guitar solo, and they change. It's kind of the same riff. It goes like that, but now they're doing it on the fifth position, so in the seventh fret. Just to, you know, it just kicks up the song, makes it a bit more interesting, just than just keeping it on the same harmonic position, the same all the. Throughout the song. I want to listen again. This is the first phrase of the guitar solo. Since we're up here in the fifth position, something like that. This is not the exact note for note transcription or anything. I'm just doing this by ear. It's a pretty cool lick. Yeah, so it's all something like this. Something like that. It's basically just pentatonic position, except for the very first lick. I wonder if it's Doug Aldrich that's playing that solo. It certainly sounds like Doug Aldrich. Let's keep listening. It definitely goes back to the root position of the song, which is, I'm gonna call it E, it's actually C. And he's playing, whoever is playing, I guess it's Doug Aldrich again. Something like that. pretty cool melody. It's like kind of the pre-chorus, right? Only one time. Back to chorus. What can I say? Awesome band, awesome fat sounding song, big drum sound, big roomy drum sound. The kick is, for example, the kick is really fat. It's not, it's dominant, but it's not like a clicky kick. It definitely sounds more like hard rock than metal. It has a really low tuning, and the vocal performance is awesome. The bass playing is awesome, and I love the guitar sound. That's it, people. It's a little dissection, little analysis of the song Holy Ground by the Dead Daisies. Hope you liked what I had to give, what I had to say. If you agree and if you don't disagree, please comment. Let me hear your thoughts down in the comment box, and see you next time.